Hey, in this video, I'm going to be sharing for newbies how to better track projects inside of Airtable so that nothing falls through the cracks and everything gets wrapped up nicely and you stay organized. But not only that, I'm going to be sharing with you one of the best kept secret scripts of Airtable. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Gareth. I own Gap Consulting, and it's my mission to help you save over 20 hours of your time every week with no-code tools. If you'd like to learn more about how we do that for our clients, you'll want to start with my automation webinar. It's going to teach you the fundamental building blocks of using no-code automation so that you can automate those repetitive admin tasks that you're doing day in, day out. If that's of interest, check the link below, visit me at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and you can get that delivered directly to your inbox. But without further ado, let's hop into the actual heart of this topic. We're talking about project management, putting together projects and tasks inside of Airtable so that you can keep track of what you need to do and deliver to client expectations within a project. As I promised, I'm going to be sharing with you one of what I think is the best kept secret in Airtable. So let's go ahead and hop into my screen, and we're going to actually start with a blank template here, and I encourage you to follow along. You can do this, build your own version of this, and of course make changes where applicable to you. I'm going to hop into the upper right corner and add an app, and I'm going to go ahead and plop in here. Now you may have noticed that all of the plans now, even the free plans of Airtable, allow the installation of apps, at least one on the free plan. But beyond that, we are going to be using scripting here. I know that that can be a little scary for a lot of folks. It is for me. I'm not a coder. Everything we do here is going to be point and click. So let's move on into it. Before I go into just scripting, I'm actually going to go for marketing teams, and I'm going to go a layer deeper. I'm going to scroll on down here, and you see a few scripts that Airtable has set up. They think that they are great scripts for marketing teams, but in fact, I think that this script right here, creating records for multiple templates, works best for project and task management. So I'm going to install this little script right here. You too can do this. No matter what plan you're on with Airtable, scripts are currently a free offer across all the plans. And I'm going to go ahead and add that script to my database. It's going to get added here on the right-hand side, and then it's going to take me directly into it. And I have to do some mapping here. Now, of course, I have a brand new blank template, so I haven't built any of this stuff. The first four questions, parent table, type table, template table, and child table. You'll notice that all of these are tables, which are the tabs up at the top of my Airtable base. I don't have any tables yet except for the default one that it started with, so I better go create these. I'm going to create a project table. That's going to be my parent table. I'm going to create a type table. This is where I'm going to store the different types of projects I'm going to work with. I have a template table. This is where I build my little templates for the different tasks I want to create for these projects. And I'm going to create my tasks table. That's going to be my child table. This is an easy thing to do. Let's get it set up. First table, this is my default table. I'm going to rename this to projects. No big deal here. I'm going to delete all the extra stuff here. I don't need these extra fields, but I'll be adding more fields later. I'm going to add another table, create an empty table. I did that just by clicking add here at the top. And this will be my child table or my tasks table. Again, I'm going to delete those extra fields that I just don't need here. My next field is going to be my type. These are the different project types that I might work on. Maybe you have different services that you offer in your business. Most of us do. When you take on a project, if it's type one, you're going to have certain tasks assigned to that. If you take on a different type of project, type two, the tasks are different. Different scenario, different type of project. And that's where we're going to delineate between the different types of projects that we offer. Now, the last one here is our template table. And this is where we're going to actually build out the template where we have certain tasks assigned to certain projects, so that every time we add a new project of a certain type, that script is going to know what tasks to create for that project, because that data is all going to live here in my template table. Just as I did with my other tables, I'm going to delete my extra fields. I will leave my primary field, the name field, where it is, and I'll come back and mess with this later. Back into my scripting app here on the right-hand side of my screen, I need to assign those tables now. Remember, projects is my parent table. Type, I've named that table type. Where's my template? I called my template table template, trying to keep it easy. My child table is tasks. So the only ones that I didn't match exactly to the way that they're categorized here are my projects, which is my parent, and my tasks, which is my child table. Now moving on past here, we have the type. So it's asking me, where is the linked record in the parent table to the type table? I don't have one yet, so we've got to go back and build a little bit more in our database so that we can map out this lovely scripting app. So let's pop back into our parent table. Remember, that's projects. And I'm going to build a linked relationship to my type table. So this will be the type. And again, this has to be a link. And when I assign a new project a type, it's only going to have one type. I won't take on a project and assign it multiple types. So I make sure to toggle this off, allow linking to multiple records. I don't want this. I'm only going to allow link to a single record in each instance. Create this field. And now I can go back to the right-hand side of my screen where I'm setting up my app, and I can tell it that this new field that I just built, this record in my parent table, is type. Now let's make sure that we know that there's a difference here. So I'm going to actually rename this to type link. I don't want you to get this confused with the type table. It's not the same thing. So I'm going to save this as type link. And as soon as I do that, in fact, Airtable is smart enough to know this is the type link field. So let's not confuse our fields with our tables. The next one here, template type. This is the linked record in the template table to the type table. So let's build it. In my template table, I go here and I create a link to the type. And this is the type link. And I'll call it type link 2 just so we don't get it confused. And in this case, I'll build another link here, link to my type table. And again, each template record is only going to get assigned one time. So let's toggle it off in terms of this particular linked relationship. Create that field, go back to our app, and we're now going to say from our template table, the template type is that type link 2 that we just built. There we go. Child field in the template table. This is a text field in the template table to indicate the name of the record. So let's fill out a little bit of information inside of our template table, because this seems a little nebulous right now. So I'm going to say, all right, first let's go into our type table. Let's say we have three types of projects. Then on my template side, I'm going to link to these different projects. So here are the different links to type one. When I am building out this template, I'm saying, hey, when I take on project one, I'm going to have three steps. Or tasks. Step one, step two, step three. These are all steps that have to occur for type one of my projects. I can build this out for all my different project types. So again, for type two, I'm going to have some, and for type three, I'm going to have some as well. Let's make this a little easier. We can group by my field here. I'm going to group by this field so that we can see, these are the steps that are pertaining to this particular project type. These are the steps that pertain to this one. These are the steps to this one. So we can build these out. Whatever these steps or tasks are that you're doing within each type of project you take on, this is your template where you get to add those different things here and play with them so that they match your particular customized process. When this thing is fully built out, we're going to be able to add a new project, run our script, and automatically create the different tasks that we require for that particular type of project. So now that we've put all these names in, we can see that the text field where we're storing the name of these different tasks or steps, this is all in the name field. In fact, I'm going to rename this. This is going to be my name template in parentheses. Again, I am just doing this so that we don't get it confused with any other name field anywhere else. So back to the right-hand side where I'm setting up my little script. I'm going to choose that from my dropdown. Remember, this is the text field in the template table to indicate the name of the record. And we have called it name template. Moving on, we have the template record order. So what is this? A number field, notice right here, a number field in the template table to indicate the order that these records need to be executed. This is an important one. If you have things that have to occur in a particular order, you definitely want to lean into this. So let's build an order field here. Easy enough to do. This is a simple number field as we were clued into from the text on the app. So I just set this to an integer. And here I'm going to say, this is the first one, the second one, and the third one. In this case, maybe this step 45 is actually the second step. Step 46 is actually the first step. And then step 47 is the third step. So to make this a little bit easier and cleaner to look at, let's now add a sorting to our template so that we can see it more precisely. Right click on the order field, and I'm going to go down to sort. And now when I do this, you'll see that it rearranged the order of the different things within each group. So I do get this question a lot, but yes, the grouping is going to take precedence here. As you see, we are grouped by the type link, and then within that grouping, the order is taken. So here I am within type 2. I have reordered these things, and you can see that step 46 is now above step 45. Now that we've created that order field, we can go back to our app setup on the right and choose the field. It is the new order field that we just added. We're almost done here. A couple more fields to set up. Now we have to choose the child record order. This is the number field in the child table to indicate the order in which the records need to be executed. So we have the order field in the template table, but we don't have it in the child table yet. The child table, if you recall, is our tasks table. So let's plop in there, and I need to build an order here, and I'll keep this unique by calling it order tasks in parentheses. I'm going to come down here and drop in a number field. This is the type of data that lives here. Again, I'll choose integer and create that field. I can delete this because we haven't actually created any tasks yet. So I'll delete all my existing records, and instead I will come over to the right-hand side once again and assign this field. This is my order tasks in parentheses. Moving on, I have the child name. This is the text field in the child table to indicate the name of the record. As you might have guessed, that is my text field right here, the name. Just to keep it unique, again, let's call it name tasks, just so that we know what we're talking about. So again, I'm going to come down into my app setup and I'm going to choose name tasks. All right, last one. What is the parent field in the child table? Check this out. This is the linked record in the child table that indicates the related parent record. Remember, the parent records here are projects. The child records are tasks. So where is my linked relationship between project and tasks? That's probably the most obvious linked relationship, and yet we haven't built it yet. It's the last question. So let's go ahead and plop it in here. I'm going to connect to my projects. And again, just to make this unique, I'm going to make sure to call it projects link in parentheses. I built a linked relationship from my tasks to my projects. I want every task to only be assigned to one project. So again, I'm going to toggle that off and create the field. Lastly, I'm going to come down here, choose that field that I just created, projects, parentheses, link, and that's it. I have set up this thing. Now here's the thing to note. If I want to edit this code, if you are a fancy JavaScripter, awesome. You can come in here, tweak this code all you want. You can plop on in, give it a second to load. All of this code, I could not write. Guys, I am not a script writer. I wish I was. I wish I had better coding skills. But the point of Airtable, the point of no code tools, is that you don't have to know this stuff. All of this was point and click, and now I'm going to have a beautiful script that runs on the background and allows me to create my tasks automatically. So let's pop out of here. This is all set up. Again, if I want to tweak it, if you want to tweak it, you can. It's over my pay grade. I'll let you figure that out on your own. So let's plop into projects now and add a new project. I'm going to delete these old projects that we have. And I'm going to say, hey, we're taking on a new project. We're working on a new project for Gap Consulting. Very cool. I'm going to expand this all the way out. What type of project is it? You might remember we've got a few different types. We've got type 1, 2, and 3. Type 3, I never built anything for in my template, so I'll ignore it for now. But let's say this is type 1, whatever the heck type 1 project is. I assign that, and I can go over here to my script on the side of my screen and click run. It's going to ask me to pick a record, and I'll say, well, I want to create new tasks for this project. Go ahead and plop that in, and just like that, I have now step 1, 2, and 3 created for this particular project. Let's go into my tasks table and see what it's done. It created the 3 tasks. These are the 3 different things from our template that occur every time we have project of type 1. And it's put these things in order. So here it is saying these are the different things you need to do, and this is the order they need to get completed. And you'll notice that they are linked back to my project here through that connection. So let's make a tweak actually to our template. Let's say our template isn't fully baked. And in fact, we have a few more steps that we forgot to add here. So I need to go back into my template and say, there's actually step 4. That's the 4th thing that we do. Once I add that, Airtable takes a second to think, it reorders the records, and this is now a part of my template. Please note that this won't automatically create a new task for my existing projects. My original project of type 1 still only has those 3 steps. But if I want to run this again, well then, it's going to create 4 new tasks that are based on the template as it currently is, which includes 4 different things. So I pick that record, I tell it, yep, that's the one. And what's it going to do? Over here, we see that it created 4 new tasks, assigning them to that particular project and giving them this order. So this is the type of thing that you probably only want to run one time unless you need to add some extra tasks or go back in and make some tweaks. Just to round it out, let's make sure that our tasks are going to be automatically created for the different project types. So I'll call this another project. And in this case, I'll assign it to my other type of project, type 2. Come on, there we go. And once I'm set up, I just click run. Again, I'm going to choose this new project to create these 4. If I plop into my tasks, we're going to see that we got these things created. And remember that we changed the order of these tasks. We made step 46 the most important, or the first of these different steps that has to occur. This isn't a very clean way to look at my tasks, so I will probably want to group by this field, and I will probably want to order by my order number here. And the last few pieces that you'll probably want to add to any kind of task management system is who's in charge. We'll add a person in charge here. I'll use a collaborator field type. This allows me to add anybody who I've shared my database with. In this case, it's just with me. But if you have a large team that you've shared your base with, you can add anybody on your team. And then, of course, I also want to track completion. And so I'll have a checkbox field type for the completion of these tasks so that I can just mark them off as they are done. There are a lot more tools within Airtable that you can use to better visualize this data. I would encourage you to explore the Gantt view and the timeline view and even the Kanban view so that you can utilize this tool to its fullest extent. I've done a lot of videos on those in the past, so I'll be sure to link to a couple of them below. I hope you got a ton of value out of this. If you did, be sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss upcoming videos, and I will see you in the next one.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.